Good evening, everyone, and welcome back to the video with the Monkey Sending Sensei. I have an excellent panel of guests with me today. We have Ryan Murphy from Rush Fans. I have Evan Stevens from Rush Fans as well. And Tyler, why don't you give your channel a shout out? Where are you from?
LP Tremors. As of right now, we're on a little bit of a break, but my channel is LP Tremors, where basically I just talk about vinyl and horror movies.
Awesome. I checked out your channel. Pretty good stuff.
We are all from Iron Maiden Lyrics now on Instagram.
Absolutely. Yep.
We all run Iron Maiden Lyrics together. So, yeah, an awesome team.
Excellent. Awesome. So this video is essentially a post-reunion era set list. So it's a what-if situation. So I actually came to Ryan originally to do a ranking of the classic Iron Maiden lineup. And then he suggested to me, why don't we do a set list of the post-reunion era? So everything from Brave New World up until Senjutsu. And I thought that was a great idea. So for mine, I came up with 15 songs with a encore of 3 songs. So Tyler, why don't you go first?
Yeah, absolutely. So I figure that there's no better opener. Well, as far as the post-reunion era of Iron Maiden goes, there is no better opener than If Eternity Should Fail off of Brave New World. So that is my opening track. Everything from the atmosphere to the intro to the eerie vocal delivery from Bruce. I adore this track. It's a perfect way to open up if we're talking about modern day Iron Maiden or post-reunion era. So If Eternity Should Fail at number one, and that's going to be followed up by New Frontier off of Dance of Death. From New Frontier, track 3 is going to go Ghost of the Navigator. At 4, Stratego off of Senjutsu. And right after Stratego, I got Writing on the Wall. And track 6, we are going to go to the Final Frontier record with Coming Home. So Coming Home at 6. At 7, I have different Worlds off of Matter of Life and Death. At track 8, I got Rainmaker, so going back to Dance of Death. And that's going to be followed up by Passchendaele, continuing on Dance of Death. And at track 10, I have These Colors Don't Run. And now we're going to get into a bit of a ballad sort of feel. We have Darkest Hour off of Senjutsu. That's going to be track 11. And we have the epic When the Wild Wind Blows at track 12. So that's going to close the main set list. Now, once I get into my encores, it's going to open up with the title track, Dance of Death. And that's going to be followed up by Journeyman, which I always considered pretty much Dance of Death Part 2. So I thought that would be a perfect way to follow up Dance of Death. So I got Dance of Death, Journeyman, and we are going to end the entire show with Blood Brothers off of Brave New World. And that's all I got.
Solid.
I'm kind of smirking a little bit because you got a lot of the same picks as me and a lot of the same spots as me. So we'll get there, I guess. But
okay, so before I read this off, I do just want to say, post like 2000 and onward, Maiden is the era that I am the least familiar with. Like, so much so that I didn't even start listening to it until a couple months ago. So there might be some, I don't know, like obvious picks on my list, but we'll just see how it goes. Let me get into it.
It's fresh.
And another thing, I didn't necessarily think about order or like order of the set list either. So these are just kind of 15 songs, I guess. So starting with number 1, we have The Wicker Man. Then number 2, we have Ghost of the Navigator. I think those two tracks back to back from Brave New World are just, they're amazing. Continuing with Brave New World, we have The Fallen Angel. And then possibly my favorite song from Brave New World, we have Dream of Mirrors. I tend to like the longer Maiden songs, and Dream of Mirrors really scratches that itch for me. Next, we have Rainmaker, probably my favorite song from Dance of Death. It's phenomenal. And also only one of two songs, or excuse me, one of three that I picked from Dance of Death. Next up, we have These Colors Don't Run. And then after that, The Pilgrim. Next is Out of the Shadows. After that, my one pick from the Final Frontier, The Alchemist. And I threw that one on there just because that song is like textbook Iron Maiden for me. It's like dorky subject matter, but still with kick-ass instrumentals behind it. Fantastic. Next is Monsigur. Monsigur. Not sure how to pronounce
Monsignor,
it.
yeah.
Monsigur. Okay.
Monsignor,
Next is another one I can't pronounce. Passchendaele.
Passchendaele, yeah. Passchendaele,
Okay, cool. And then next up would be A Different World, and I figured for the encore I would just do three Senjutsu songs right in a row. So I did Days of Future Past, The Writing on the Wall, and then Death of the Celts to close it off.
Nice.
Awesome. I did not include Day of the Future Past, and I should have. As soon as you said that, I'm like, oh no, I should have included that. Such a good song.
I feel like that's one of the songs from the new record. Well, new record, you know what I mean. But that's like I think one of the best songs that they could do live. At least I think so. I don't know. I feel like it would translate well to like a live setting.
It would
Definitely.
definitely. Oh
I mean,
yeah.
so you said you didn't order these in any particular order, right? But
Yeah, I came up with that
I
last
mean,
bit like literally 5 seconds ago that I'm just gonna do these three as an encore.
well, I mean, it kind of
Yes.
works.
Does work.
Oh, well, there we go.
Especially with Wicker Man and Ghost of the Navigator 1 and 2. I mean, the Wicker Man was like the quintessential opener for like how many tours, like post
Yeah,
reunion, right? I
true.
mean, like, so it was definitely,
Yeah.
yeah. And I think playing three Senjutsu songs in the encore is pretty interesting idea too. So
Were
I
there
like
any
how
on my
you.
list that any of you guys didn't pick, maybe?
No, I like
That
that
you
you
can
included.
remember.
I really like that you included The Alchemist. I'm kind of pissed I forgot about that one.
Of
I don't have
the
Fallen
Final
Angel or
Frontier
Dream of
songs I'm
Mirrors.
familiar with.
Yeah.
Sorry, what was that?
I don't have a lot of these actually, but I don't have Fallen Angel or Dream of Mirrors. Like, a lot of people bash Dream of Mirrors, I feel like. At least on Reddit, like the Iron Maiden subreddit. And I kind of like it. It's not for like,
Yeah, I think
it's
it's
not a
great.
song for
Solid.
like
It's a
every
good
mood,
song.
but it's a good song, yeah.
One of the longer ones.
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
For sure, yeah. So our buddy David couldn't make it tonight, and he sent me his set here to read off. And I'm gonna do that. I don't have any explanations for anything, but maybe we can discuss it as a group afterwards. Maybe I'll tell him to leave a comment and explain some of the choices. But he opens with Isle of Avalon from Final Frontier.
Final.
Ghost of the Navigator, Death of the Celts, The Great Unknown, Death or Glory, Journeyman, These Colors Don't Run, Days of Future Past, and out and closes his opening set with Out of the Silent Planet. And then his encore opens with The Wicker Man. Then he has The Writing on the Wall, and he closes with Empire of the Clouds.
Holy shit.
Which, yeah, which is kind of like, I think that kind of makes up for the fact that he doesn't have 15 songs or whatever. Like, he, you know,
Yeah.
I mean, that's like three songs in one. So
At least.
I like it. I think it's, well, yeah, by
Yeah,
Maiden
nothing
standards,
unique.
it's like three songs in one.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's a cool set.
Yeah.
It's definitely unique and definitely out there. All right. So for my set, I'll just read through it and then I'll go back and explain, I guess. So I start off with If Eternity Should Fail. Then I go into Stratego, The Writing on the Wall, Monsigur, These Colors Don't Run, The Longest Day, Lost in a Lost World, The Alchemist, Tears of a Clown, Out of the Silent Planet, The Thin Line Between Love and Hate, Brave New World, and I close with When the Wild Wind Blows. And my encore opens with Darkest Hour. And then we go into Dance of Death and we close with Hell on Earth. So, reasoning. Everything Tyler said about If Eternity Should Fail is the reason why I picked it first. I think it's the opening, you know, spoken word and all that. It's an instrumental. It's fantastic. Stratego and The Writing on the Wall are just, to me, a great second and third track for Senjutsu, great second and third track on the I guess, second leg of the Legacy of the Beast tour back in 2022. And then I go into Montsegur, a song that I don't think was ever played live that I'd love to hear live. I think it's just a banger of a track. These Colors Don't Run. The Longest Day, probably my favorite from A Matter of Life and Death. I think, I don't know if this was played live, wasn't it? I think all of A Matter of Life and Death was played live, right, on that tour. I believe the
Yeah,
whole album was
yeah.
played live,
Yeah,
but
the
there's no
entirety of that
album.
album was played, yeah.
But there's no CD or vinyl or DVD or anything of that, right? So there's no,
No.
maybe there's bootlegs, but Lost in a Lost World is one that nobody's mentioned yet. And that's one of my favorites from Senjutsu. And I think this kind of takes the spot of like where Sign of the Cross was on the last tour. Kind of right in the middle of the first set, long song. Love it. Evan said The Alchemist, but Tears of a Clown, great tune. And then Out of the Silent Planet and The Thin Line Between Love and Hate, my two favorite songs from Brave New World, both are fantastic closers. That's why I put them right near, or well, second, and then closer right near the bottom. Same thing Tyler said with When the Wild Wind Blows, great closer. I didn't just go through and just pick all my favorites. I went through each of the six records and picked my two favorites from each to get me 12 songs, and then I added three. So I wanted some diversity. The first time through this exercise, I just said, all right, let's just do Senjutsu top to bottom, right? Like, which Iron Maiden teased that they might do in the future, I guess. I think it was Bruce, said that that might happen. Still hasn't happened yet, but I'm hoping for that. But would have loved to see that. Yeah, Darkest Hour, I think with the opening, like, water that you hear in the background and all that, and there's like a little bit of spoken word that like whispering in the song. I think that just serves as a really cool, you use the word ballad, Tyler, like a really just an interesting kind of slow form song to open the encore, which then of course that feeds right into Dance of Death, which would be super cinematic in my ideal set list here, and closing with Hell on Earth. I mean, it's a fantastic closing track on Senjutsu. I kind of wish this closed the Future Past tour. I don't think it is. I think it's in the encore. I could be wrong, but I just feel like this is a great send home track. So that's my set. Thoughts?
Yeah. No, it's solid. I mean, you're right. You're pretty much right on point with me, like you said.
I was surprised that you included Tears of a Clown. That's kind of a
Yeah.
contentious song among some of the fans.
Well, I mean, so like I said, I was picking my two favorites from each record and then filling in. So If Eternity Should Fail is by far my favorite from the Book of Souls.
Yeah.
But Tears of a Clown is right there. It's near the top. I kind of was debating that, or when Speed of Light came out, I really liked that song, but that's kind of fallen down my list. But The Red and the Black is a great song too, but I also felt that that was just so long, and I wasn't trying to kill Bruce in my set either here with all these long form songs. So I went with that.
I was really close to putting Out of the Silent Planet on mine, so I'm glad to see at least a couple of us put it on there. That's such a great track.
Another song I never played live.
Absolutely.
Derek, what do you got?
All right, so from my set list, I took a lot of stuff from the first two records and a lot of stuff from Senjutsu. I'm not really into the middle period because that's when it starts getting, the album started getting really long and kind of long drawn out for me. So I'm not as familiar with Book of Souls, Final Frontier, and Matter of Life and Death as a lot of other fans are. So I had a little bit of issue picking some songs. I was upset I couldn't pick anything from the Deano era because that's my favorite era. So that was already gone out. But to start off, I did the first three songs they played on the Legacy of the Beast tour. So you have Senjutsu, Stratego, and Writing on the Wall. I think it's just the perfect way to start the concert, playing some new stuff, songs of two longer ones and a shorter one. And then I have the Wicker Man coming up after that. A nice short bursting track from Brave New World. Then we have Rainmaker, which I love that like riff that opens that up. It's perfect. And then going from Rain, I have Darkest Hour closing out the opening part of the set. So again, with that water in the beginning, it's kind of a nice ballad, nice break, short intermission. They come back with The Alchemist. Fast, heavy tracks. One of the songs I actually like from Final Frontier. And then we go right into The Fallen Angel. Another great shorter one. Dance of Death. Nice sort of ballad, mid-tempo. Wildest Dreams. Opener, Dance of Death. Another short one. I love that one. And then track 11, we have Hell on Earth. The closer, Senjutsu. Again, peaks and valleys. And then to close out my main set, I have Monsegur. Really heavy track, really great way to get the crowd pumped for the encore. Which for the encore, my only Book of Souls track is Speed of Light. The only song I really know off of that record. Again, I kind of phase out after, it's kind of a long record. And then we have From Senjutsu, we have The Time Machine. Kind of a deep cut that they might not ever play live, but one of my favorites. And then to close off, I have The Thin Line Between Love and Hate. Another one of those peaks and valley songs. And the way it closes and the way Bruce sings that closing line, oh, gives you chills. They were to end the concert.
So are you thinking, Derek, that they're going to break like after the writing on the wall as well before they go into the Wicker Man? Kind of like what they did in the Legacy of the Beast set where they did the first three Senjutsu songs and then they paused and like tore down the set. And then you could just like open with the Wicker Man. That could be like a second opener.
I was thinking something like that. Yeah.
When you were explaining it.
Like act one, act two, act three.
Monsegur is your closer. Explain, please.
I don't know. I just really like how heavy that one is. Like as Maiden get further, they kind of drift away from the really like heavy, just like darker tracks. But Monsegur is like really pounding and it's a great way to end the set list. And it makes the fans like want an encore because they're still pumped to hear more songs. And then Speed of Light comes in and just puts the wrecking ball down.
I like it. First pick for Wildest Dreams, too.
Yeah.
Anyone else got anything to add before we log off?
I think I'm good.
Yeah, I mean, watchers of this, I guess, leave your sets in the...
Well, thank you guys so much for watching today. I appreciate Tyler and Evan and Ryan for coming on my channel, setting this whole thing up. It's been a blast. Don't forget to listen to Rush. Up the irons for Iron Maiden. And don't forget to keep meditating with Vine.
Sweet.